I'm Kirby. Welcome back to Affordablerc. Today we are taking a look at this, the Shinglong 9136, 1/16 scale, four-wheel drive truck. So let's get into it. All right, welcome back to Affordablerc. Kirby here. We are looking at the Shinglong Toys 9136, 1/16 scale. It's a 4x4 ready-to-run truck. It comes with I think it's a 40-amp ESC, a 1.8 kilogram steering servo, I believe. 7.4 volt, I think. Yes, 500 milliamp battery. Full ball bearings, high output, I believe it's a 390 size motor. And a CVT style dragline. Other features that it has, and looking at the box itself, waterproof level basically to the bottom of the chassis. And it's ready to come up. Pistol. And on the bottom of the box, that wasn't taped very well. Shows you the basic battery installation, charging instructions, the remote setup, the trim setup, and battery installation. That's pretty much it. In the box comes the truck, obviously. Look at that first. Well, might as well go through the other stuff. You also receive the charging unit. And oddly enough, there are a pair of lights here that you can plug into the receiver. So you can have headlights if you want to mount those into there. Taking a look at the radio. Get the boring stuff out of the way. That's the wrong one. Again, fairly standard pistol remote. Three double A's, not two. Your throttle and steering trim. Steering, throttle. Forward and back. Foam cover on the steering wheel. On off switch. Fairly generic, fairly standard issue. And this is the little truck here. Hang on a second here. Get it out of the box as well. And this is the little truck. As everybody notes, it has no oil in it, in the shocks, so it'll be fairly bouncy, but I will show you later how to get around that problem without having to buy anything, or buy any parts anyway. One thing I'm noticing is there's no paint on it. They've got the decal package done on the inside, but the rest of the vehicle is completely transparent. Fairly interesting. Not sure if that's a mistake or if that's the way it's supposed to be. Alright, so here we have the truck. Here's your receiver and electronic speed control. The battery is here. 1.8 kilogram steering servo. 390 size motor with heat sink on it, which is a great idea. This little dial here, you just turn it one way or the other. It unlocks the top tray, you can pull your battery out and charge it up. 500 milliamp, 7.4 volts. So that is the truck from the top side. You notice it has non-adjustable front and rear links. So you can't set the camber, you can't set the toe in. The single shock on each corner. Totally independent suspension, which is great. And the bottom is very nicely contoured. The one thing that I prefer not to have on my RC cars are Phillips screws, but a toy grade, I don't really expect them to put a lot of money into high-end fasteners. So with the spoiler on there, it looks pretty sweet. Like I say, it is going to go. It's supposed to be 38 kilometers an hour. We'll check that out. It is four-wheel drive. And it looks pretty snappy there. I'm going to now charge the battery up for a bit and we'll take a look at it outside and see what it does. So stay tuned. Be right back. So before we take it out to see what it can do, I did want to take a look at a couple things. I thought I'd bring you along for the ride. First wheel nuts I've ever taken off with a Phillips screwdriver. As tight as these are in there, those wheels are not going to be backing off anytime soon. I don't know if it's spinning into the tire wheel itself or the housing inside on the axle. But we'll take a look, see what we get. Alright, so it is just a locking, instead of a solid steel pin, it is a plastic hub sitting in there. So that's one thing you're going to have to be cautious of. If you are jumping it, don't be on the throttle when you land, because you're going to shave all those plastic connections out of there. That's not going to last very long. That's a little disappointing after them going to the effort of putting a CB joint in there. Ball bearings. And again, putting this on, be very careful, because you may end up pushing that on crooked and completely destroying that wheel. Look at the length of that bolt. But yeah, like I say, I wanted to check to see how it was all put together inside there, and I'm glad I did, because this truck is going to be for my grandson, and it's going to have to be, I'm going to have to be very strict. He's used to using his slash, it's a 1/16 slash, and that thing's almost bulletproof. It's got a superior design to that. But overall, it's a pretty impressive looking little toy for the price of it. It should be good. So like I say, well, I did notice now that on the back, you can take these studs out here, you can take them out of the bottom, and you can move the shocks to the front. You can do the same thing on the front, you can move them to the back. Which leads me to believe they're probably just universal arms, either front or back. Which is great if you're replacing them. If you have a front left one, you'll also have a right rear one. Anyway, we'll go from there, we'll take it outside, see what I can do with it. Thank you.
crawler. Oh, it's upside down. Little top heavy. Stay away from the trees. Feels a little better with that full battery. Even with that camera on there, does not want to flip over. So much traction, though. Nope, and that's why it's in a case.